what I'm thinking about when I'm sourcing my material is like, how can I converse with an individual that might not have a fine art background? And I think when you're painting or when you're working in the traditional methods of making work, it becomes kind of a exclusive language to the people that are familiar with that. And I think when you're working with everyday objects that people come into contact with every day, there's more of a potential to connect with somebody that might be outside of that world. And that's what I'm interested in doing. So my practice involves working with found object and pre-existing materials. And I think I was interested in the durag and seeing how I could unlock that, and knowing already that it was an object that had significance. But I didn't necessarily see it as like, I'm gonna start to make these durag paintings or like use the durag long term in my practice, if that makes sense. It was more of like, okay, like let's see what object is going to be interesting. And like, I think this is the first work also I've made that is a bit more reactionary. And like, once you get past the idea of like, okay, it's a durag, and like the conceptual nature of the work, a lot of the other stuff becomes like color studies and playing with texture and the physicality of the material itself. So the first work I made was a piece that was dealing with violence against black bodies. And maybe that's why it was received so well when it had come out. It was at, I don't know if there was a height of like any, because shit's always happening, but this was around the time that the Mike Brown incident had happened, and there was a lot of protest. And I had made this work, and it was less about like police brutality and more just about like the violence that you as like a black male faces. Because I mean, if we're talking about like perception and stereotyping and law enforcement getting involved, having a hoodie on or a durag and walking through a neighborhood might bring that fate to you. So the idea of trying to like put these things in a space where they're normalized and not vilified is not a direct attempt at addressing something like police violence and brutality, but I feel like those conversations can be had within the work. I know for sure that other artists have worked with the material before. I know John Edmonds, he's a photographer, that I admire a lot. And he's been doing work that involves the durag, but it's been more photography. But he prints these photos on like silk, and they're like flowy. And I think the execution of that work is also very tasteful. Yeah, I guess that's the only other durag artist I really know. Like, I used to watch a ton of black shows, and I give reverence to those, but I think I was also, when I was like really coming up and I was like really being influenced by culture, I was like a big fan of Dave Chappelle, of like Lupe Fiasco, of Pharrell, shit, Andre 3000, anybody that, you know, I was like a black kid in Missouri, and like, I felt like I was kind of just weird, and like, I was able to get myself into so many different things in the environment I lived in. And those were kind of like the people that showed me that, you know, like Lupe Fiasco read manga, but also rapped and skateboarded, but was also from Chicago. And like, I don't know, there's just like, I'm very interested in individuals that are able to like, promote individuality and like being yourself. I'm excited. I feel like I'm actively trying to find out how I can like do shit from like the ground up, you know? Like, I'm actively trying to find out how like I can work with other artists in the city or like within my community to like make moves or make things happen. I feel like that's a draining, kind of like daunting idea of like, you know, work until somebody sees it. And I'd much rather like continue to make work because I'm gonna do that regardless and find out how I can create a demographic or market. And I think that's why I decide to use the material that I decide to use and try and like show and put the work out to the audiences that I choose to cater to or show my work to.